Hopefully I won't forget. I will make a note. I hope. Per. Three things per. You know what I mean, right? So. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today another style tone unboxing. This one is the month of September. Yes. Well, September box. As per usual, I also give you my thoughts on the products from last month's box and tell you if I think they are worth it, if I like them. So basically a mini review on the stuff that I got last month. And then this month, I will give you my first impression of the products that are in this month's box. Yes? Oh, the makeup I have on my face, I filmed. It is a combination of stuff that I already have, but also obviously stuff from this month's box. And I also used some products from last month's box, just so you know. I will show everything to you while I'm kind of discussing the products. So yeah. What else? Yeah, the eye look I filmed, but it's not in this video. It's the first look with the Nubian Coral palette. Because, yeah, I'm also planning to do three looks with that palette, and this is the first look. The makeup that I have will all be listed down in my description box. I think I'm forgetting stuff, but I don't know. Oh yeah, the earrings I made myself. So yeah, that's, yeah. I will leave my playlist of my unboxings down in my description box, and there will be some other information down there as well, so go check it out. Just click the, I think it's the show more or the little arrow, and then you kind of get a drop down. You know, you can find a lot of information down there. And this was from last month's box, so you need to go here. I don't know. I always ramble, but with these types of videos, I feel like I'm extra rambling. Does that make sense? Anyway, the Style Tone box is a Dutch subscription box that you get every month. You can pay per month, 3 months, 6 months and a year, I believe. And it is around 15 euros. I usually forget what the box really is. So I am just kind of, it used to be 12.50, but I think now it's around 15. So let's just keep 15 in mind and we are good, I think. But yeah. You usually get five full-sized products in the box. It is always cruelty-free and they try to be mostly vegan as well. You also get a booklet about the products that are in there, what they retail for, a little bit information, sometimes some tips and tricks on how to use them, that kind of thing. So yeah, I think that's everything I wanted to say. Let's just go into last month's box first. I will leave a timestamp down below. If you just want to see what's in this month's box and my first impression, you can click the timestamp. But I will start with the stuff from the August box. Okay. I'm hungry. Of course I am. So the first thing that was in the box was the Hydra Matte Pore Correcting Velvet Cream from Fix & Rouge. It retailed for 35 euros. It's cruelty free and vegan. They say it's like a primer, use it after your moisturizer, before your makeup. I also always, I use sunscreen after my moisturizer and then a primer on top. To be quite honest with you, I don't think it's worth 35 bucks. Oh, it contains salicylic acid. Oh, I did not know that actually. Oh, so I'm reading the tube, which is actually the first time I'm reading the tube, and it says something extra than is in the booklet. It says here, Pore Correcting Velvet Touch Smooth Matte Cream. Innovative pore perfecting formulation with a replenishing and hydrating matte effect. Yeah, it is a little, it gives a little bit more of a matte effect, but usually most of my primers do. Brightening complex with vitamins A, C and E helps restore natural radiance. That's all good and dandy. I have that in my skincare and there is a layer of sunscreen in between. So I don't think that those vitamins can get to my skin through my sunscreen. But I know that vitamin C can help boost your sunscreen. So I don't mind it too much that it is an extra layer. Purifying and perfecting salicylic acid helps unclog and reduce pore size. A smoothing hyaluronic acid helps restore long-lasting vitality. And that is basically the problem, I think, now that I think about it. Hydrating primers, it's all nice, but it goes on top of my sunscreen. So I don't know how effective that is, but it does help to keep my face from drying out extra. I don't really like hyaluronic acid in all my skincare products because hyaluronic acid dries out my skin if I overuse it, and I have it in my serums and probably in my moisturizer as well. So yeah, it says here blend into T-zone and over enlarged pore areas with fingertips. So I put it around my entire face. So I'm going to try it again, but then just on the T-zone area because I did not focus it there. I haven't used it a ton. First impression was I did not really think it was worth the price, again because it didn't grip it here. But apparently I should have read better because this is a different product than I thought it was. I will reserve judgment. I still don't think it's worth 35 euros, but that is just me personally. I will keep on trying it and I will let you know next month. Hopefully I won't forget. I will make a note, I hope. So yeah. So a jury is out on that one, but I still don't think it's worth the price. The next one was from Dirty Little Secret, a lip gloss, which retails for 14 euros. And it is cruelty free and I think vegetarian. Is that the leafy? I don't know. This is the color Nude Beach. There were two colors in here. I got a Nude Beach. I really, really like this lip gloss. You don't need a lot. I kind of tend to want to have a lip gloss layer because I'm used to that because the lip glosses I used to use were a little bit more of the gloopy formula, you know? So I was really used to, putting a lot on my lips, basically. You don't really need a lot with this one. It's nice and moisturizing. It smells nice. Not that I particularly care, but I like it smelling nice better than having it not smell nice, you know. So it smells nice, it feels nice and hydrating. It has a tiny bit of golden sparkle in it. I really, really, really like this lip gloss. I actually need to stop myself from using it in every single look that I do because it goes with so many looks. Today I put it on top of a lip liner that I will mention in a little bit because it's a lip liner from this month's box. I don't know if you can... It smells like vanilla. I don't know if you can see it here, but it is, I don't know, a nudie gloss. I have itchy nose. It's a nudie gloss, but it's so pretty. It goes with so many of my eye looks. I am so happy that I have this one. So yeah, is it worth the 14 euros? Yeah, I think it is. I think it's really, really worth its money. I'm very, very happy that I have that one. Okay. Next we had, the blush palette from Bella Pierre. Here it is. It contains 6 blushes. It retails for 30 euros. It's cruelty free and I think also vegan. I don't know, I have a leafy thingy and I have a V thingy, I don't know. It's a magnetic packaging and it contains a mirror. This is what she looks like. I have been using this a ton, especially this blush shade, because I think this blush shade is really, really pretty. I've used this one as a bronzer, not really as a blush, because for me it's too brown to use as a blush and too dark. I can use it as a bronzer though. I have used all the blushes, I think, except this one. Or maybe I did use it. I don't know. They're pretty, they last a long time, but this is my favorite. I keep going back to this one. It's pretty light though. I can make it work now, but I really have to pack it on. That is just because I have my summer color now. But I really, really like this blush palette. Do I think it's worth 30 euros? Yes, because if you then bring it back to per shade, it's definitely worth the money. This is a really, really good quality. I forgot the names are on the back. So yeah, I use this a lot. I have to say to myself to not use this as well. So, yeah. It's really, really good. I can highly recommend, actually. Then we had from Daily Concepts a multifunctional soap sponge Mother of Pearl. I have the... This is the picture. It was... I showed it in last month's unboxing. It is was kind of a weird texture. It is a piece of soap, obviously. One side is smooth, the other side has a little bit of bubbly texture. I don't know. I used it. It's nice, but I do not like the soap residue if I use a bar soap. I have it with every bar soap that I use on my body. I don't like that residue feeling. So I've used it once. And that was the first and the last time. Just because I don't like the residue feeling that it leaves. So yeah, it's not my cup of tea. Let's keep it at that. I do think it's worth the €6.95. Yeah, I do think that. I don't hate it. I just don't use it because I don't like the aftermath feeling. Okay. Then we had from Secret Spa Hair Trio. So these were sachets or satchels. I don't know how you say that. Hair trios. Yeah, it was one was a serum, one was a shampoo, and one was a hair mask. Per three things per. You know what I mean, right? So you had basically a hair serum, a shampoo, and a mask. That's basically what I want to say. I gave it to my sister because I don't need it. I don't know if she has used it yet. So I have no idea. And that was it. Yeah, that was everything that was in last month's box. Do I think it was worth the money? Yes, I do. With the exception of this one that I kind of need to try out again. And this time use it the way it's meant to be used. I have no opinions on this one just yet. But just these two were definitely worth the money for me. So yeah, very, very, very happy that I have these two in my collection. I use them a lot. Okay, let's go to this month's box then. Which is the box of September. This month it is 100% vegan and paraben free. I don't give a rat's tail if it's paraben free. I always say I would rather have parabens than fungus. And parabens are not bad for you. Unless, of course, you are sensitive to them. Then maybe they are. But they are a preservative. And yeah, does not really matter. Let's just stop before I rant. Well, obviously, I have used everything. And that is in this month's box. Oh yeah, by the way, I also used the blush box from last month's box. And I used the lip gloss, just so you know. So I will do probably a side screen like I did in last month's video. And show you the side by side of me talking. Or maybe I will even put it over. I have not decided just yet. But yeah, let's go to the first item. That is from Dr. Botanicals. It is a cocoa mask. It retails for €9.90. And it's 30 mils, I think. Let me see if I can read that. Made in the UK. Oh, it's on the front, really? Okay, so I had to stop recording for just a second because, well, there was a crisis. So if I'm in the wrong frame or I'm looking a bit sweaty, it's because I am. Okay, never mind. Let's just go to the first thing, which is from Dr. Botanicals. It's this. And it is a cocoa mask. It's cruelty-free, vegan and vegetarian or something. I don't know. I have a leaf. And then I have a V leaf. I don't know, people. It says how to use a thin layer on your face, not the eyes. After cleansing and scrubbing, I don't scrub my face, but okay, fine. Let it sit for 5 to 10 minutes and then rinse off for maximum result 2 to 3 times a week. And it is best stored in the refrigerator. And that was my mistake the last time because we also got a pomegranate mask a while back. That was really, really nice. It was last year, I think. But it went bad pretty quickly because, silly me, I did not store it in the fridge. So yeah, it's 30 mils. Really? Anyway, it's 30 mils. The main ingredients are cocoa butter and coconut oil. I'm curious to try this. I really liked the pomegranate mask until it went bad. You could smell that it went bad, you know. And we also got a face oil a while back from Dr. Botanicals. That one was really, really nice. So yeah, I cannot wait to try this. It says reviving hydrating mask. So I'll probably try it tonight. I'm curious. So yeah. Yeah, so that's annoying. Let's do that not. So let's go with then. Really, this is so annoying. So anyway, I was just looking through the booklet and I want to go in order of application because I filmed the application and they kind of start with the last thing that I put on my face, you know? So I need to go back in the booklet. So let's start then with this one, which is from Laritzi. It's a contour stick and you could get two colors, Aloha and Mahalo. And it looks to be that Aloha is a little bit cooler and Mahalo is a little bit warmer. So you see me using it. I don't usually use contour sticks at all. And to be quite frank, this is, I think, I'm very bronzed today. I don't know if I like it. I feel very tan. But here it is swatched. I think it's a bit too warm for me to contour with. If I use this, I will use this as a bronzer more than I think. It looks pretty on my skin though. It played nicely with the rest. It played nicely with my foundation. Blended out really, really well. I just usually don't use stuff like this. I will try this one though. So yeah, I have mine in the color Mahalo. It's cruelty free, vegan and vegetarian. I don't know. I have those two same things again. It retails for a whopping 24 euros. Wow. But yeah. It's nice. I think that the color is pretty. I'm not really going for a very bronze look at the moment, but maybe if I, because now I also use my powder bronzer on top, maybe if I don't do that, just use this and then use a face powder to set it instead of bronzing powder, maybe I'm a little bit less bronzed then, because I don't know if I like that very, very bronze look on me. But anyway, it's nice. I will keep trying it. I don't know how many mils it's in is in here. Let me see. 9 grams. So yeah. So yeah, nice. Yeah, it feels nice. I don't know. I don't know if it's worth it. I know that I would not pay 24 euros for a bronzing stick, but that's me. But yeah. So yeah, that was that thing. Yeah, now I need to sure, because we're going backwards anyway. Let's then go to this. This is from P Space, I don't know. It's nail polish. And I have the After Hybrid. Because you could get four. You could get Ridgeway, SOS Hydra, After Hybrid and Instant Heart. Pun not intended, I think. Or maybe I just have a dirty mind. Anyway, I have the After Hybrid. And it's a nail conditioner. And it says here, harder and stronger nails. After 2 weeks of use, repairs nails and protects against breakage. Use twice a week. Oh, now I can see what my how my nails are looking. They're looking dirty. But yeah, I'm actually quite curious about this one because my nails are, well, getting a bit softer now again. So I'm actually really curious to try this. So I will try it and let you know in next month's unboxing. It retails for 10 euros. Yeah, I kind of see that. Yeah, I don't think that's a weird price for a product like this. Okay, and next is from Bella Pierre. It's a highlighter palette. You have 5 shades. They are not named. I just say 1 to 5. You see me swatching them as well. This is what it looks like. And it's pretty. The swatches were pretty as well. They showed up on me. I think that a lot of skin tones can use this. I think some are too dark for me, but you know, you could also use this as a shimmer palette for your eyes, if you were so inclined. I have this one on my face, and I name it number one. And yeah, I think it looks, honest with you, this is a very creamy formula. I think it's nice. I think it gives a nice sheen without a lot of glitter. Yes, it's plastic, but it feels nice and sturdy. 24 euros. Yeah, I can kind of see that. Because again, you get 5 shades. I cannot wait to play with this during the month. Because so far, I've been really, really liking the face products from Bella Pierre. I love the blush palette. I think this one is very, very pretty as well. So yeah. 24 euros. Yeah, I think that's an okay price. I think I already said that. I don't remember. What do I have then? Oh yeah, and then the last thing that was in the box is a lip pencil. I just started with this and then thought, oh no, I also have a bronzing stick and such. That's why I had to refilm the tiny piece. And I'm going backwards in the booklet now. Could have gone backwards either way. Oh, that would have been fun. Yeah, I could have stopped. Never mind. Anyway, lip pencil from... Yeah, the I want to say Douce, but it's with double C. So, it's like... this. Here's the name. I don't really know how to pronounce it. Doucet, Dookie, I don't know, people. I don't. But anyway, it's a lip pencil. I have mine in the color Luna. And that is number 478. There was this one, a red one, and I think a berry one, or maybe a dark, deep brown berry. I don't know. Anyway, I'm actually very glad that I have this color, because this is a color that I was looking for. I have it still swatched here on my hand. When I feel it, it feels stiff and hard. And I thought it would probably tug on my lips. It doesn't. Actually, you see me applying it here. It actually went on not really, really creamy, but creamier than I thought it would, actually. And I think that the color is really, really pretty. I paired it with the lip gloss from last month's box. And the combination is really, really nice. So, yeah. This was me just applying it. This is after drinking coffee and such. And the lip liner is still here on the outer parts. It's still there. I just put on a little bit of extra lip gloss. Just because I can. But yeah, I think actually this pencil surprised me. Just because of the fact of how it feels when I put it on my lips. But yeah. So, and it retails. Wow. I just see what it retails for. It retails for a whopping 20 euros. There is no way in hell I am going to pay 20 euros for a lip pencil. Just so you know. I have BH Cosmetics. It's really nice. I have Catrice. They are really nice. I'm not going to pay 20 euros for a lip pencil. So in my opinion, no. I definitely don't think it's worth it. But I am very happy that I have it. What would I pay for this? Yeah, I don't pay more than 5 euros for a lip pencil, to be quite honest with you. So yeah, 5, that's about it. But yeah, overall, I'm very happy with everything that is in the box this month. I will get use out of everything that is in this box, which I don't think has ever happened before. So yeah, I think it's definitely worth its money this month. And this makes me excited for next month's box and see what they have in store for us then. Let me know down below if you have the Style Tone box. And I'm actually really curious to hear your thoughts on the stuff that were in the box last month. Specifically this one, the Figs and Rouge primer. How do you like it? How do you use it? Do you use it only on your T-zone? Let me know down in the comment section below. I'm going to give you my final thoughts on the products from this month in next month's unboxing. And keep an eye out for my description box, because I usually, if I have room there, list the makeup that I have on my face. So you will probably see a few of these products during the month, because yeah, I need to test them out for you guys. So yeah, guys, that was it for me. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.